Alright, today in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to actually save images from Cricut Design Space, so your designs, and actually save them to your computer so that you can print them out regardless if you're in Cricut Design Space. So you can print them out for any reason at all. And this is a tutorial specifically for Mac users. I know there's a lot of tutorials for Windows, but I couldn't seem to find one for Mac. So I thought I would show us Mac users how to do this from the print and cut screen. So I'm actually going to be using this with my Sublimation printer. So I actually don't need Cricut Design Space for this project. So I actually want to save this to my desktop. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you how to do this. So first thing we need to do is we actually need to change this to a print then cut image. So I'm just going to select all the elements here. And I'm going to go up here under Operation in the top left. And I'm going to go down and I'm going to select print then cut. And then you see here it even changes the image style so that it's better quality for printing. So I'm just going to go through and I'm going to repeat this process and I'm going to change all the elements of our design here to a print and then cut. So it's just going to take me just a second here to get all these done. And then once we've gone ahead and we've done that, you will see we still have this outline here, our cut outline for the mug press. I actually don't need that. And we won't be able to go to the next screen with that on here because it's too big for a print and cut for Cricut Design Space. So you'll see here you have down in the bottom right, see how it gives you that little hazard symbol? And it tells you it's not supported by the Maker 3 because it's too large. So what we want to do is we actually want to click this. And we're just going to hit delete. So I'm going to hit delete on my keyboard and that's going to get rid of that. Now these layers here, the markings for where it's going to be placed on our mug, we actually don't need those either. We don't want to print those out. So I'm just going to delete those as well. So now what we're left here is with our print and cut image. So what I want to do here is I actually want to highlight everything before we go to the next screen. And I actually want to attach it. So we're just going to come down here and hit attach. And then we're going to go ahead here and we're going to go to make it up in the top right. And then once this loads here, we can see our design. So we're just going to go ahead and we're going to, actually, I'm going to go ahead first. I'm going to mirror this because I want it to print out backwards anyways. We're going to go ahead and we're going to hit continue. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to send it to our printer just like we normally would with a print and cut. But then instead of actually going through with printing it, and I'm just going to actually make note here that you want to actually turn off the bleed lines. We don't want those bleed lines because then it looks really thick. We want to go ahead and we want to turn on Use System Dialog. So what that's going to do when we go ahead and we print it, it's going to open up a print screen. So it tells you here, important, after clicking print, your print dialog may appear behind your Design Space application. So if we go ahead here and we hit print, we just get this loading circle. But if I actually go ahead and minimize my screen here, we see our print is behind it. So this is where we can actually go into here and under PDF, if we click that down, we can actually save it as a PDF. So then this little screen pops up and we can just save it as Santa. This is a custom mug for somebody. So Santa custom mug, that's what I'm going to call it. And if I could actually spell there. Okay, so Santa custom mug and then we save it. So now when we go into our Finder here on the Mac, here it is, Santa custom mug. And we can open that at anytime we want, and we can go ahead and print it directly from this screen. So we can go down and we can print, and then we can use this design anytime we want, regardless if we're in Design Space or not, and we can just go ahead and print anytime we want right from this screen, or sorry, right from the design are saved on our Mac computer. And then we can just go ahead and go right back into our Cricut Design Space and we can just cancel the cut because we're not really actually going to cut it or print it from there. So we can just go ahead and cancel that. And then like I said, now it is in here in our Finder, saved on our computer. And we can go ahead and we can print that anytime we want. I hope that this tutorial is helpful for you. If you have any questions, feel free to put them down in the comments below and I will try to answer them the best I can. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more great Cricut content and DIY content coming your way.